Hey guys, welcome to The Market is Open. Check out our website, themarketisopen.com. I wanted to go over some of the takeaways from this interview that Ryan McGaffrey from the Ride the Lightning podcast had with Franz von Holzhausen. From here on, I'll just say von Holzhausen. No, just kidding. I'll just say Franz. He's the chief designer at Tesla, and he came to the company after working at Mazda, and he's designed the Model S, Model 3, Model X, Model Y, the Semi, and the next generation Roadster. But before we begin, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. We would really appreciate your support in helping us grow our channel. Also, remember to hit the bell button and please share this video on Facebook, Twitter, and of course, Google+. You can also support us on Patreon at patreon.com/themarketisopen, where we have some exclusive content. And check us out on Twitter at themarketisopen. Okay, now in my opinion, Franz and the team are not just designers at Tesla. I think they have a very important role that they're also the marketing team at the company because the cars are designed to sell themselves and he and his team have a big role in making them look great. I guess Franz is kind of like the Johnny Ive of Tesla. Both of them are chief designers. Of course, Johnny Ive is no longer with Apple, which shows that it's not really about one person, but assembling a talented team for the company. But Johnny Ive was like a one-man marketing team for Apple. He was always in the new commercial each year. However, it seems that Franz is more focused on the product, which I like, and I think it's cool. And he also brings together design and physics, which come together to create a beautiful and functional vehicle. Okay, so one of the main things that gets me excited about Tesla is that Franz is excited about Tesla. He's asked in the interview which car that he's worked on is his favorite, and his answer is the next one, which is a pretty interesting answer, the next one. Now, a lot of people don't finish the project that they're working on and they move on to the next one a little bit too soon, but Franz's team have a great track record of completing projects. So that's really great, of course, and it's interesting how he's excited to work on what's next. Even the Model Y had its own challenges as it had to have the functionality of vehicles in its class and stay within the constraints that he was given. So to me, it's going to be pretty cool to see what the underhyped Model Y has in store for us. But I like that he's very excited about rethinking what a transportation vehicle will look like once we have autonomy. So to me, that's great that Tesla has products in store for many years in the future. And I'm excited to see what the Tesla team comes up with. I mean, there isn't much competition at this time, of course, since nobody has self-driving. But I feel like some of the things I've seen out there are a little bit laughable. And I'm also pretty impressed that Tesla as a whole has become a lot more secretive about their projects, it seems, or maybe they've always been like that and I haven't really noticed. But I think that's really great for surprising people and getting them excited about the products. He also talks about the new Roadster 2020 or 2021 now, I guess, which he says will be better in every way than the prototype that was announced. The Roadster specs are already pretty groundbreaking. It will have a 200 kilowatt hour battery, 620 mile range, that's 1,000 kilometers. So it's pretty insane for any car. Though the Roadster is clearly only for those people who have money to burn, but I think shareholders will be quite happy to see the car dominate the high-end market. He also talks about the palette of colors that is available for vehicles and is asked if there will be more colors. He said he's quite happy with the color palette, and I think that's really good. That's very disciplined, actually. Tesla was having a lot of problems with too many colors. That's why they choose one color to be standard, and I guess they switch it up from time to time. For example, it used to be black, and now it's white. I guess all the colors are pretty much the same price, but it's hard to switch away from the default color, which is why they charge a lot more for a different color. Plus, also, if you need touch-ups, Tesla has to make the paint available to all of its service centers, so that adds a lot of overhead. So having a limited palette is really smart, and I'm glad Franz answered the question the way he did. Now, if I had one question for Franz about the company, I think I would ask if he's contributed to anything non-vehicle related, specifically the factory itself. Tesla and Elon are about the machine that builds the machine, which is in fact Tesla's actual product. So I wonder if the Gigafactory has any design elegance or some efficiencies that came from Franz just walking around the Gigafactory and noticing something that could be done different or looking at the plans and making some changes there. It's almost sort of like how Steve Jobs made even the inside and the back of the Macintosh computers look beautiful. I wonder if the Gigafactory, which isn't really customer facing, contains any contributions from Franz and team, and if not, then why not? Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. This is our new TAMIO stock channel. Please subscribe, we'd really appreciate your support. Also remember to hit the bell button. Let us know in the comment section below if you have any questions about Tesla that you want to see answered, or any other type of stock market content. Thanks for watching.